Hey guys, this is RedHood420, and I'm here to bring you some Arrow news from Comic-Con. They released a trailer for the Arrow panel, and I just want to briefly talk about my experience with Arrow. I have watched it all the way from season 1 to season 4, and Arrow season 1 through 2 were one of my favorite seasons out of that show. It was one of my favorite TV shows at the time when they aired those seasons. There was nothing like it. This was before Daredevil came out, Jessica Jones, and Arrow was at its prime. And right when season 3 hit, I want to say episode 9 for season 3, it went all downhill. They ruined a lot of characters that I liked in Arrow. They made characters very hypocritical and all that stuff, but that's for a different video. I just want to talk briefly about this trailer. And in the beginning, they do the close-up shot of Damian Dark and Oliver with the city. It's basically a Dark Knight Rises battle. They basically copy and pasted that. So we finally found out what the promise was for Laurel, and it was that he needs to not be alone, which is okay, cool. That is what the writers were hyping. They were like, oh, this promise that Oliver has to keep with Laurel, it's going to be so amazing to find out. And it just was all right. Okay, so we got more shots. Of course, we're gonna get a new team. The whole other old team is disbanded. Of course, Diggle's going out to do his own thing because he feels guilty about having a role of Laurel's death because of trusting his brother. And Thea is realizing that she is kind of messed up. It's not the bloodlust talking, it's her own actions and having a sword to a girl's throat, which is pretty crazy. The whole reason for this disbanding was to focus on Arrow. Arrow is a show, and it was very overcrowded, and I understand why they did it, but now they're going back and saying, oh yeah, we're gonna have a new team. Wild Dog and Evelyn Sharp. Evelyn Sharp is being played by Madison. I don't care for Madison's acting abilities whatsoever. I think she's a very bad actor. She did not impress me when she was pretending to be Black Canary, and how they wrote her character. It just boggles my mind and why they're going this direction. And supposedly she's gonna be Artemis, and I'm just not looking forward to her. And we have Wild Dog, which I have no opinions on because he's brand new, and Mr. Terrific wants to be a vigilante, which I just don't really care. I mean, his character is cool, but like, to me, his character is more of another clone of Felicity. But that's what I think on that matter. But we get into more things about flashbacks. The flashbacks are going to be set in Russia and him joining the Russian gang because he had that tattoo of Bratva. It's basically, you know, the Russian mob. He's going to have this journey to become a more cold-blooded killer that he was in season 1. Another interesting thing to look at from this trailer is the new costume. It's not really a new costume. Stephen Amell has always said that the new costume that he wore in season 4, I believe, made him more cold because of it being sleeveless. They just added sleeves to it, which is cool, I guess. Not gonna be that same look that we have in season 4, just with sleeves. Another thing to take note is that there's a new main villain. You see him at the ending of the trailer. He kind of has a scarecrow mask, but he has kind of like an Arrow-ish costume, and he has a sword. And I have an idea who he's playing. They said that the main villain, which is what we saw, is Prometheus, which I'm still a little salty that they're doing this, that they keep using more Batman villains like they did with Ra's al Ghul and Deathstroke. I love Deathstroke in Arrow, and they did their own spin on it, and I liked it. But then Ra's al Ghul, they're doing the whole reason that I didn't like the Ra's al Ghul thing was because Batman is the heir to the demon. That is who he was supposed to be. Not Oliver Queen. And the way they portrayed Ra's al Ghul was not a perfect representation of who Ra's al Ghul is supposed to be. You guys are probably wondering what I think of the trailer. Did this entice me to come back to Arrow? Is it going to make me so enthusiastic that I think there's hope? There has to be hope. No, I don't think there's hope. This trailer just proves to me that Arrow isn't what it should be. It seems the choreograph might be better, in this season, the way he's actually taking on the recruits, taking on the newbies of the team with the training. And I like how they're doing that. That's a pro for this trailer, but there's nothing else that entices me to watch it. There's just not much to go on in this trailer, and there's not much to hype up for this trailer. I'm not as hyped as I was for the Flash trailer. I'm not as hyped as I was even for a Daredevil teaser and all that stuff. It's just because Arrow had two bad seasons. And I don't care if you guys go in the comment section below and tell me, yo, Red Hood, it's because the writers were gonna do the Suicide Squad representation. No, that's not the reason. Everyone keeps putting that in the comment, defending Arrow and saying that's the reason. That the DCEU basically pulled the rug out of him. No, that's not the reason why. It's just they had bad writing. They couldn't come up with anything else. This is the problem. We have two showrunners that don't understand the characters. Wendy and Mark do not have a good track record of being showrunners. For crying out loud, Mark was a part of the Green Lantern movie. Like, really? You're gonna have this guy be a showrunner? Ugh. There's a lot of people in the comments saying, yo, guys, I think Arrow's gonna be good. Season 1 and 2 writers are back. So, the most logical thing that I did was search it, and nothing's coming up for Season 1 and 2 writers are coming back. I'm just like, okay. So, are they coming back or are they not? Why? How is everyone finding out about this? But I'm not. It's not posted on any, like, major website outlets such as IGN and all that other websites. I'm searching in the, you know, Google search bar and it's not showing up. So, I don't know. It might be true. It might not. Do I have hope if it is the writers from season 1 and 2? Maybe, but we're still having the same showrunners. Wendy is not doing a great job as being a co-showrunner with Mark. It's just not. But what I think coming back and reeling this back is, only thing I liked was the choreograph for the fight from what little we saw. But guys, I'm going to be making a video of who I think Prometheus is going to be. It's going to be coming out soon. There's more videos to come from all that Comic-Con news. But guys, let me know, are you hyped for Arrow Season 5? And let me know if you want to watch all of Arrow Season 1 through 4. Let me know what is your favorite season. Guys, share this video with your friends. Hit that like button if you like the video. If you want to see more content from my channel, hit that subscribe button. It helps me out a lot. So guys, this is Red Hood 420 signing off.